We're kind of running out of time. We've got another panel session. I wonder if there are any questions, very briefly, for Minister Popovsky. I see there are not. There is one.
Yes.
Very quick one.
Thanks. Actually, I'm not going to be directed by you. I'm going to ask a question to the Pakistani gentleman.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Because it's the Media Freedom Conference, and you're not going to shut down questions about a censor. You censored me, sir. I have a Twitter account in Canada, and because I wrote something that traduced some Pakistani blasphemy law, you complained to Twitter, which took down my tweet in Canada. So can you explain why your Islamic supremacy in Pakistan is silencing my personal and journalistic freedom in Canada? And I know it happens in the United States too. And frankly, you sure should be embarrassed to invite a censor like this. But back to the thug. Who the hell are you to censor me in Canada? Answer.
Now, I don't like...
I know you don't because you don't like free speech.
I don't like...
You don't like free speech.
Okay. Would you like to answer that question? I just respond to you, sir. First of all, you want your sentiments to be respected. Just look at the tone and the talent you've adopted. Is that the correct way? You have a right to ask questions.
Well, then why did you censor me?
Did I censor you?
You shut down my Twitter tweet.
I did not.
Don't lie.
How am I responsible for that?
Because the government of Pakistan did. The government of Pakistan.
I'm respectful to you.
No, you were not. You censored me.
I did not censor you.
Don't lie.
All right. Why would I lie?
Because that's what you do.
Okay. No, we don't. I'm sorry.
Shame on you and shame on you. Shame on you and shame on you for inviting him. Shame on you. You censorious thug. You censorious thug.
And what you call freedom, at times you are projecting certain sectoral agendas.